None of us want to be frustrated in our lives, and so we do everything in our power to make sure that we avoid getting frustrated. And that's why most times when frustration comes, it either takes us unawares, and before you know what happens, it keeps you down. Frustration in most cases leads you to depression, and before you know, you have thoughts of suicide. As unimaginable as it sounds, we should plan for frustration. You know how you draw your itinerary and you make your plans, your goals? Also create room for frustration, because every day there is going to be one thing or the other that can frustrate you. Example, you're trying to go out, you're in a hurry, and you probably need for work, and you don't know where you kept your car keys. It's enough to drive you crazy. Sometimes you're trying to read and you can't find your glasses. You know, this morning I was trying to write a couple of articles, and I sat down really trying to concentrate and write, and my dad called, my mom called, there was a knock on the door, my phone rang. It was annoying, and I started to smile because I was actually writing on this topic, and I realized that frustration cannot be avoided. You can only try, but you can't avoid getting frustrated. Now, one of the major things every day that keeps us frustrated or gets everybody frustrated is when your effort does not equal your outcome. Sometimes we work so hard, and so we're expecting a lot of positivity from our hard work, and it doesn't turn out in most cases the way that we plan, and so you get frustrated. And there are a lot of reactions that come from frustration, one of which is anger. Most times when you work so hard, example, there's an artist that has spent so much time recording, working in the studio, sleepless nights, and he eventually brings out a song, and before you know what's happening, it's either the song is not getting the amount of airplay that he hoped for, or people do not like the song as much as he worked hard on it. It's enough to frustrate you, and that's why most times the quickest reaction to frustration is anger. And the next thing you know is you hear people that are frustrated say things like, I give up, I quit, I do this. And that's why I am actually addressing frustration this morning, because in most cases, a lot of people have given up on their dreams just because they got frustrated. And life is unpredictable. Anything can happen any day. And that's why you have ups and downs. You have the high moments and the low moments. And that's why, you know, I like the serenity prayer that says, Lord, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, the courage to change the things that I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. But what I do as a Christian is every day I pray for grace. You know, you can be confronted with situations, and if you're not in the right frame of mind and you do not know how to handle it, it could lead you to break down. One of the easiest ways to deal with frustration is this. Understand the difference between what you hope to achieve, what you might probably achieve, and what you have achieved. This alone can help you, because life, like I said, is unpredictable. Anything can happen, but understanding that what you think you can achieve might not come out the way you hope to achieve it, it helps you be able to deal with frustration. I hope today this video helps someone, and please do not give up on your dream because of a temporary setback. Always put the goal that you could achieve ahead of you, because most times understanding the price that you are going to pay for greatness helps you be more focused and persevere more. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope that this video helps someone.